You're watching TravelVids.tv. My name is Dean Parman, and in this video, I want to talk about one of the core principles of why we as humans want to create travel videos. And this also just so happens to be the reason why we have this channel and why we want to teach video creation in the first place. By the way, this video might also give you some insight if this is the right video learning and travel channel for you. So the first thing is the main principle of creating travel videos. I'm going to tear a page out of Gary Vee's book where he says, don't create, document. And I quite like this approach because that's exactly what a travel video is supposed to be. It's a documentation of you going on an experience, to try something new, to be in a place that is unfamiliar, to try new food, to meet new cultures, to get away from the norm. That is what experiences that mean something to us are. This is why we value weddings and birthday parties, because they are not the norm. It's an experience that we value. What's important to note here is that it is about you. Regardless of the location or the occasion, it is your unique experience that we want to share with somebody else. This is why we create travel videos or experience videos in the first place. Because the people we care about, our friends, our family, or even our audience, they want to know what it was like for you there. If not, they might as well look at some stock footage or the brochures or just, you know, generic images of the place. It's about you, and we shouldn't be afraid to admit that. I recently went to Sintra, I made a video about it, and you know what? It was about my experience. I didn't make that specifically for me to watch on my own. I wanted to show my parents, who are not here in Portugal with me, where I had gone, what I had experienced. And that's okay. That's why I made the video. And in the video, you will see lots of shots that look like this.
Supposed to be a really good view. All the way down the valley. This is the view today. We're gonna look the other way.
Because once again, I will repeat it. It's about my experience. And I documented that for others to see. The people most dear to me are going to be invested in my journey here. And even if I'm growing a YouTube channel, then it is my audience that is invested in my journey too. And if you don't put yourself into the video, you're not gonna have that. You might as well just be a generic channel. Of course, you could be really good at making cinematic videos, which do capture a lot of attention, but that is not the main principle or the main core reason why we create these videos in the first place. So, here is the problem that I see with travel video creators, or to be more specific, amateur travel video creators, people who are going on holiday and want to capture their experience. Not talking about people who do this for a living, who have experience in video creation. This is what you do wrong. Number one thing is too many people are obsessed with what camera gear they have. Is this the right camera? Is that the right camera? Do I have the best thing of this? Do I have the best thing of that? It's yes, all of this will make your video better. I will not deny that. But it doesn't affect our core principle. It does not contribute to the fact that you're telling your personal story. It only adds to the aesthetics, which, as we've established, is something that is more important to the professionals, and it's something that you can add on later. It's the second part of the process that you need to learn. Because if you take that on as the first principle, if you start working on the aesthetics first, you are not going to enjoy your experience because you're going to be obsessing over, have I got the shot? Have I got this? Did I do that? And you're completely forgetting to actually be on vacation, on holiday, on your travels, being somewhere else, being in a very unique situation that you've probably paid a lot of money for. Do not waste a second trying to make something that is beyond your level. And here's a little caveat. Even if you have the gear and the skills, which I do, to make a mind-blowing, out-of-this-world travel video, I wouldn't do it unless I was being paid to promote a destination or location, or I was making a choice to make this video for a specific channel that follows that style. For me, it is about capturing the experience. So when I went to Sintra, I took my phone and I enjoyed myself there and just so happened to make a cool video along the way. I'll take this a step further because the second point is closely related to gear. It's about the techniques of filming. Do I have the swooping, gyrating, transition built-in shot? Again, these are wonderful to have. People really appreciate them. But if you're making this video to share your experience with friends and family, then these come second. And just to prove my point, we don't devalue this at TravelVids. We have got content about creating cinematic footage with a smartphone. You can check the card up here now. There's a playlist on this stuff and we will create more of this. There are tips and tricks that you can employ to make your videos aesthetically pleasing. But take this as the second step. At TravelVids, we are committed to teaching you a basic video that you can make as fast as possible with no previous video experience that has an emotional arc. A story that people can connect with. So here are some practical tips to take away from this video. Tip number one, film a snippet of yourself talking to camera at every location you go to. It might be uncomfortable in the beginning, you might not be used to this, and also believe you me, you might cut it out and never use it. That's fine, you have to start practicing. Get used to the idea that when you're in a new location, you have a certain experience, become aware of that experience. How do you feel? Switch the camera on and share it with somebody. It's simple. It can be a one-liner. It can be a single sentence.
I can't get enough of it. I am standing in a Moorish castle today.
Share what is happening, even if it is obvious. Because it's not about describing the situation. It's about revealing the emotion. This is how we tell a story. You don't have to sit and script the story or know the first thing about storytelling to make a successful travel video. The only thing you have to do is document the emotion you are feeling in the very moment. The second thing is get lots of reaction shots. This is very similar to the first point, just without talking to the camera. Turn the camera on yourself, do a little bit of the selfie thing. I know it feels a bit awkward, but again, it's revealing of your experience. The third part is more shots of you, this time further away, and for that you're going to need a little tripod of some kind where you can put your phone on that, put the phone down, walk away and just walk by, walk towards. Just getting a couple of those shots to change the perspective in your video. Again, it places you in the environment, which is more important than just seeing the environment because the stock footage can do a better job than you can. You see how the pattern is pretty much the same. It's just a little bit less focus on what you see and more focus on yourself seeing it. If you found that information useful, then subscribe to TravelVids.tv, the channel where we teach video creation to absolute beginners. And we have a heavy focus on making you capture your experiences in the easiest and fastest way so that it doesn't interrupt the experience itself. My name's Dean. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers for now.